I'm Angelina Lippert. I'm the chief curator of Poster House. And since you can't come to the museum right now, we thought we would give you a little behind the scenes tour of the museum while we're closed. So we're starting with these pieces by Jules Charest. Jules Charest is known as the father of the poster. He is basically the first person to perfect large scale color lithography for commercial purposes. And this piece is really amazing because it's progressive proof. Progressive proofs are incredibly rare because usually a printer would only print one to test how each different color separation would align when in a completed poster. So if you get closer to this piece, you'll see a beautiful young woman. This is known as a charrette. Charest made over 1,000 posters in his lifetime, and you'll see a repetition of the women that he uses in these posters. So most of them are blonde or redheads, and they're usually very vibrant, very vivacious, and they kind of like jump off the page. And so this character appears in so many of his posters that they got the nickname charrettes. And this piece was originally designed for a Parisian department store, but the department store rejected it for some reason. And the person that took it up instead was Edmond Sagot. And Sagot is the first major print dealer that dealt in the sale of posters, which is how posters survive today. No poster that you see in a vintage poster store or gallery was ever pasted on the street because it would have been destroyed if you tried to remove it. Paste is very temperamental, and this paper is incredibly cheap, so it would have been destroyed if you tried to take it off the wall. So any poster that exists today was either stolen as it was being put up, or it was bought from a dealer like Ed Sagot. The other interesting thing about this piece is it is a two-sheet poster. So you'll see a seam in the middle. That means that as this poster was being printed, two different stones would have to be used to create a final image. And not really just two stones, but as many stones as you see sheets of paper behind this central image. So for every color used, a separate design had to be made. And through a resistance between oil and water, ink was applied, and then that would create an image on the page. And then those images would all come together in the final product to create this poster. So the reds were printed separately, the yellows were printed separately, the blues were printed separately. And that's an incredibly labor-intensive process today, but at the time, this was the cheapest and the easiest way to make a large-scale color lithograph. As I was saying, Ed Sagot purchased this to advertise his poster and print shop, which is super poster nerdy, and I think that's fantastic. So we have this demonstrating the Belle Epoque, or the dawn of the poster period, on permanent display in the museum. And we hope you can come see it again soon.